جزاك الله خير. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. Thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى that he has allowed us to carry on with this book, and that he is allowing us, inshallah, to prepare for Ramadan, as many people do not prepare for this month, and as a result, they don't get the full fruits and benefits from this month. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to give us tawfiq to that which is best. طيب, we stopped last lesson at the Mabhath. المبحث المؤلف في سنة المبحث الثالث فوائد الصيام ومنافعه العظيمة وحكمه ومصالحه. So this chapter, in this chapter, the author is going to talk about the virtue, the benefits of fasting, and its wisdoms. Why do we fast, and what good does it bring us? He said that قال الإمام ابن جوزي رحمه الله تعالى لما كان المقصود من الصيام حبس النفس عن الشهوات وفطامها من المؤلفات وتعديل قوتها الشهوانية لتستعد لطلب ما فيه غاية سعادتها ونعيمها وقبول ما تزكو به مما فيه حياتها الأبدية ويكسر الجوع والظمأ من حدتها وسورتها ويذكرها بحال الأكباد الجائعة من المساكين وتضيق مجاري الشيطان من العبد بتضيق مجاري الطعام والشراب وتحبس قوى الأعضاء عن استرسالها لحكم الطبيعة فيما يضرها في معاشها ومعادها. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he's just mentioning that from the objectives of the siyam is to habsu nafsi 'an ash-shahawat, is to abstain the nafs from the shahawat, and to wean the nafs from that which it loves, and to adjust the nafs and its strength, adjust its power, the strength of the nafs, its power, الشهوانية, its shahawat. And he mentioned different things that, يعني, from the virtues of fasting, is that, and from the objectives of fasting, is to, يعني, to manage the nafs, and to make the nafs, to make ourselves control our nafs and not allow the nafs to control us. And this is very, very, very important. See how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, فَأَمَّا مَنْ طَغَى, as for the one who transgresses, as for the one who فَأَمَّا مَنْ طَغَى, who transgresses, وَآثَرَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا, and the one who chooses the hayat al-dunya over the akhirah, فإن الجحيم هي المأوى. And for him, the jahim, jahannam, is the abode, is where this person is heading to. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla said, as for the one who fears the position of his Lord, he fears that standing in front of his Lord, يوم القيامة, that he will be, he will stand in front of his Lord, يوم القيامة, Allah Azza wa Jalla will question him about every small and big thing. وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى, and he abstained the nafs from the desires. فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى, then for him, Jannah is the abode. See how the nafs was mentioned, and nothing else was mentioned. Because the nafs, if you have the nafs under control, and Allah has given you knowledge, and strength, then inshallah you're going to be strong upon the Sirat al-Mustaqim. But if your nafs is controlling you now, it's controlling you different things, then it is possible that it will control you in that which disobey, that in that which displeases Allah Azza wa Jal. So from the huge benefits of Siyam is that it disciplines the soul. This is the khulasa. This is the summary of what Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala is saying. He is saying that you have to go through the office. He is saying that controlling the Siyam, through the Siyam, we can, it's a means for us to have control over our nafs. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says, whoever is able to forbid the nafs from the desires and from the whims and the things that displease Allah Azza wa Jalla, فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. Then Jannah for this person is the abode. Then Jannah for this person is the abode. Then Jannah for this person is the abode. So this is in a nutshell what Ibn al-Qayyim is saying. Through fasting, you are... I'm sorry about this. So Ibn al-Qayyim is saying that through fasting, you discipline your soul, and you train it. You're training your soul to stay away from the things that you like. And the more you do this, the more you discipline it, the more you purify it, the more you make the ways of the shaitan in your blood more tight, and the more you have control of your nafs, and as a result, the more you will obey Allah Azza wa Jalla, you abstain from the haram, and you will follow that which Allah Azza wa Jalla loves. Then he said that Sawm, fasting, has a great effect on fi hifz al-jawarih al-zahir wa taqwa al-batina, that the Sawm has a great effect on not just the soul, the nafs, and the taqwa that we mentioned before, but also the al-jawarih al-zahir, our limbs, our physical limbs. So Siyam has even an effect in safeguarding them. And likewise, at-taqwa, in safeguarding the taqwa, which is inside. التي إذا استولت عليها أفسدتها. وحميتها عن التخليط الجالب لها المواد الفاسدة. It prevents it from the things, the destructive things that if it was to take over, it will destroy it. طيب فالصوم يحفظ على القلب والجوارح صحتها ويعيد إليها ما استلبته منها أيدي الشهوات. And it returns to the body and the heart that which the shahwa has stolen from her. وفهو من أكبر العون على التقوى كما قال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. And it is from the biggest means and the biggest aids upon التقوى. So you see, our nafs, we have oppressed our nafs. Like Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he said in a very beautiful qasid of his, he said أنا الظلوم لنفسي وهي ظالمتي والخير إن يأتينا من عنده ياتي. He said that I am the one who's oppressed my soul, and my soul has oppressed me. So in reality, we have oppressed our souls by obeying our soul and obeying the shaitan. We have oppressed our soul, but the soul, through our oppressiveness of it, it has also oppressed us. Our soul has oppressed us. It has changed our fitrah. It has stolen away these good things that Allah Azza wa Jalla has displaced in our hearts and in our nafs. It has stolen that away from us. And that's why we don't cry. when we read the Quran. That's why we find it difficult to pray at the night and to do these good acts of worship and to be obedient slaves of Allah, because our nafs have stolen our shahwa. He has stolen away a lot of precious things from our hearts. Allah Azza wa Jalla has placed in us when we were born, al-fitra. He's changed that. And the way to get it back, like Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, is by fasting. And it is a great means of a taqwa. We'll talk about a bit more about a taqwa in the first point that the mu'allif, he mentioned, insha'Allah ta'ala bi'idhnillah. وَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الصَّوْمُ جُنَّةٌ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, fasting is a protection, is a shield. وَأَمَرَ مَنْ اشْتَدَّتْ عَلَيْهِ شَهْوَةِ النِّكَاحِ وَلَا قُدْرَةَ لَهُ عَلَيْهِ بِالصِّيَامِ وَجَعَلَهُ وُجَاءَ هَذِهِ الشَّهْوَةِ. See how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said that psalm is a shield, and he commanded the one who finds it difficult to have the shahwa, the desire of women, is difficult on him, and he has no ability to get married, and upon him is to fast, because it will be a protection from the shahwa, because he will be able to discipline his soul. He will be able to control his soul, and his soul won't control him. Because if the soul controls you, you will end up doing all these evil things. Because the nafs calls to that which is evil. The nafs desires things which are evil. So if you control your nafs, and the shaitan, he comes to you through your nafs. If you already control your nafs, the shaitan doesn't have any control over you whatsoever. طيب. So the maqsood, أن مصالح الصوم لما كانت مشهودة بالعقول السليمة والفطر المستقيمة شرعه الله لعباده رحمة بهم وإحسانا إليهم وحمية لهم وجنة. When صيام was such a beneficial thing for the humans, Allah Azza wa Jalla made it obligatory upon them. ولله الحمد. If Allah Azza wa Jalla didn't make this obligatory upon us, a lot of us wouldn't fast, and as a result, a lot of us would have control, the nafs would have had total control on the insan. But as a rahmah, Allah Azza wa Jalla, he's made it obligatory, and he's legislated it for his slaves as a goodness to them and a protection for them. And see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَانْتَصُومُ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَانْتَصُومُ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ وَانْتَصُومُ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. هكذا يا أستاذ؟
نعم نعم.
وَانْتَصُومُ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla said that, and fasting is better for you if only you knew. If Allah Azza wa Jalla knows exactly what benefits you would get with your nafs, and in your akhirah, what benefits you will get through fasting, Allah is saying, if only you knew how good this fasting is for you, then you would surely fast, you'll surely fast more. طيب. So we start, inshaAllah ta'ala, with some of the benefits the mu'allif has mentioned. And the first of them, he said, أَصَوْمُ وَسِيلَةٌ إِلَى التَّقْوَى. طيب. He said, fasting is a means to achieving taqwa. We know that taqwa is the main thing that will save the person يوم القيامة. And it is the main thing that will elevate a person. And knowledge is only virtuous because it leads to a taqwa. And the main objective through al-ibadah, which we've been created only to worship Allah, the main objective through al-ibadah is a taqwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. Everywhere, every single Muslim, anyone who believes in Allah, wants to be honored by Allah Azza wa Jalla. He wants to be close to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he said, the thing that makes you honorable in the eyes of Allah Azza wa Jalla is at-taqwa. The more taqwa you have of Allah Azza wa Jalla, the more honored, the more beloved you become to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. A huge means of achieving at-taqwa is through fasting. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Siyam has been prescribed upon you like it was prescribed upon the people before you, so that you may achieve التقوى. The Mu'allif said, لأن النفس إذا انقادت لامتناع عن الحلال طمعا في مرضات الله وخوفا من أليم عقابه، من باب أولى أن تنقاد لامتناعه عن الحرام. He said that the nafs, if it is able to abstain from that which is halal, from food, before to achieve the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal, whilst his nafs wants this food, he's able to abstain from the food. And he trains himself to abstain from the food, and also in fear of the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَمِنْ بَابِ أَوْلَىٰ أَنْ تَنْقَادُ الْإِمْتِنَاعَ عَنِ الْحَرَامِ. So it's more befitting now for this nafs, after it's left that which is halal, for the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jalla, to abstain from what that which is haram, to in order to achieve the same thing. طيب. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, مَنْ لَمْ يَدَعْ قَوْلَ زُورِ وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ وَالْجَهْلِ فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَاجَةً فِي أَنْ يَضَعَ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ. Whoever doesn't leave evil speech and acting upon it, and ignorance, and Allah Azza wa Jalla has no need for this person to leave off his ta'am and his job, his food and his drink, because the goal of the goal of as-siyam is to leave off that which is haram. طيب. طيب. Then the مؤلف رحمه الله تعالى, he said, الصوم وسيلة إلى شكر النعم. طيب. He said, the مؤلف said, الصوم وسيلة إلى شكر النعم. There's a lot I wanna, يعني, these points are very, very heavy points, and the goal of these lectures, of these reminders, the goal isn't to just finish the book. The goal is to mention that which will benefit us, not only for Ramadan, in our lives generally. Ash-shukr, he said, a psalm is a means to achieve ash-shukr, to give thanks to Allah Azza wa Jal for his ni'am. طيب. Something very, very important to understand is that as insan, as Bani Adam, we have been created as default, we are ungrateful. We are a creation who is ungrateful. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَظَلُومٌ كَفَّارٌ. Indeed, insan is a creation that is ظَلُوم, extremely oppressive, and كَفَّار. كَفَّار means extensive in ungratefulness, not just ungrateful, but extensive in ungratefulness. The insan is so ungrateful. You've been created like this. As long as you're insan, you are ungrateful. And nothing will come out of you except ungratefulness. طيب. Okay, if you understood this, then we understand that being grateful can only come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you are able to fight this ungratefulness and change this ingratefulness, and to become now someone who is grateful to Allah Azza wa Jalla for his ni'am, this is something extremely beloved to Allah. See how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he praised the best of his creations with certain things. And from the things he praised them with is ash-shukr. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he praises Ibrahim, Khalilullah. He praises Ibrahim, the one who is the friend of Allah Azza wa Jalla, the close friend of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah praises him with ash-shukr. He said, "In Ibrahim kana ummatan lillahi." Indeed, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was an ummah. Kana ummah qanitan lillahi hanifa. He was extremely obedient to Allah Azza wa Jalla, hanifa, away from shirk. Walam yakun min al-mushrikeen. He was always going towards the tawheed of Allah, the oneness of Allah Azza wa Jalla, and he wasn't from the people of shirk. Shakiran li an'amihi. He was always grateful for his blessings, for his shukr, for his blessings. Also, Allah Azza wa Jalla, he praises Nuh, innahu kana abdan shakura. Indeed, he was a abd that is extremely grateful for his ni'am. He's always remembering the blessings of Allah Azza wa Jalla upon him and trying to give shukr to Allah Azza wa Jalla for this ni'am. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, he promises the ones who have shukr that Allah Azza wa Jalla will increase them. Allah Azza wa Jalla will increase them, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. And other than that, from the virtues of a shukr, being a shukr, and see how Iblis, he said that he will misguide the Bani Adam Then what did he say? He said, وَلَن تَجِدَ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِنِينَ. You will find most of them ungrateful. Because if you are grateful, Iblis knows what Allah, what reward Allah Azza wa Jal will give you if you are grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah Azza wa Jal said, what will Allah do with your punishment? Why would Allah punish you if you were to come with a shukr? مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ. If you were to come with shukr and iman, what would Allah Azza wa Jal do? Why would Allah Azza wa Jal punish you? This shows the manzil of shukr, of being grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal and thanking him for his blessings. طيب الصوم وسيلة إلى شكر النعم. How can you, someone might ask, طيب, if shukr is so good, and if I become someone who's shakir, someone who's grateful to Allah, Allah will raise me so high, and you push away from me the punishments of the dunya and the akhirah, how can I achieve a shukr? طيب, glad tidings to you, my brother and my sister. Fasting is a great means in achieving a shukr. The مؤلف said بأن كف النفس عن الأكل والشرب وسائل المفطرات من أجل النعم وأعلاها. لأن الامتناع عن هذه النعم زمانا معتبرا يعرف قدرها. سبحان الله. إنسان, from the reasons why he's ungrateful is because he forgets. Forgets very quickly. You give insan something, he's very quick to forget the grateful, the عظم, how great this ni'am, this ni'ma is. He's very quick to forget. طيب, when you abstain from food and drink for a certain amount of time, you start to realize the قدر النعمة, the how big this ni'ma is. It's like a similar to the ni'ma of cold water. When someone يعني, is asked, okay, what do you think about the ni'am of Allah? What are the blessings of Allah upon you? You think a lot of things. Someone might think, okay, I have eyes, ears, these limbs. But very rarely would you think cold water. Cold water? Because cold water, you're always drinking water. You barely leave yourself enough time to be thirsty before you drink water. طيب. But if you were to own the world and everything in it, if you were the owner, the king of the world and everything in it, and you were traveling on a journey. Now, you're traveling on a journey with everything you have, and suddenly you've lost everything. You've lost the way, your camel and all your provision on the camel and everything you have, you've lost it. It's gone. It's run off. It's run away. You're left with nothing. You're still the king of the world, but you've left, everything's left you. And now you go and you rest on the shade of the tree, and you're waiting for death. You're waiting for death. Come through this door. You have to come through here. Don't make noise because I've got a lesson. Okay? Now, and you rest on the tree, and you're waiting for death. And you're still the king of the you still own, let's say, half of the world. طيب. Someone comes to you now, and he's a traveler as well. He sees you on the way, and he sees you're dying, and he offers you a cup, a glass of water, just a glass of water. And he knows you, for example, you own this. He said, I will send you this cup of water for everything that you own. Will you buy this cup of water with everything that you own? The answer is yes. This glass of water will be more beloved to you than everything that you own. But the insan is always, this ni'mah is so available to us that we forget. So when you are abstaining from these things, you remember the ni'mah of Allah. And the way to give shukr is remembering. The first step of shukr is affirming the ni'mah. It's realizing the ni'mah. Realizing the ni'mah that Allah has just upon you. Then you could give thanks for these ni'mah. So through fasting, you're able to recognize the ni'mah of Allah Azza wa Jal, and then give thanks to it, because you cannot, you only realize the ni'mah once you lose it. طيب. وكذلك الطعام يحمل ذلك على شكر الله. And when you break your fast, you're able to give shukr to Allah. Alhamdulillah. الحمد لله, the one who has provided this for me. وقد جاءت الإشارة إلى ذلك أثناء الكلام عن الصيام, قال تعالى ولعلكم تشكرون. And so that you may be, so that you may give shukr to Allah Azza wa Jal. Siyam is also a means to achieve a shukr, which is a great status. And a lot of the scholars, they mentioned that the status of a shukr, giving shukr to Allah Azza wa Jal, being someone who is grateful to Allah, is the highest stage of obedience and ubudiyyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, three, الصوم يقهر الطبع ويكسر النفس ويحد من الشهوات. Then he mentioned that, like we mentioned, that through fasting, it constricts the nafs, and it breaks the nafs, and it sharpens, and it prevents from the shahwat. Like we mentioned before, siyam, and we mentioned the benefits of being someone who controls his nafs, and not the nafs controlling you. طيب, number four, he said, الصوم يجعل القلب يتخلى للذكر والفكر. طيب, we mentioned last lesson that the greatest action is ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى, remembering Allah عز وجل. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, shall I not tell you, talking to the Sahaba, shall I not tell you about that which is ألا أدلكم على خير أعمالكم, shall I not tell you about the best of your actions, وأزكاها عند مليككم, and that which will purify you the most عند مليككم, with your Lord, وأزكاها عند وأرفعها لدرجاتكم, and that which will raise you in ranks the most, the action that is the best of action, and that will raise your ranks with Allah Azza wa Jalla the most. And it is better for you than if you were to give in sadaqah, gold and silver. And it is better for you that than you meeting your enemies in jihad, but in the battlefield. فَتَضْرِبُ أَعْنَاقَهُمْ وَيَضْرِبُ أَعْنَاقَكُمْ. Not only that, but that you cut off their heads and they cut off your heads. Meaning you fight in the way of Allah Azza wa Jalla, and you are killed in the way of Allah Azza wa Jalla. What is even better than that? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Dhikrullahi azza wa jalla," with the remembrance of Allah azza wa jalla, like He is, like it, with the haqq, remembering Allah azza wa jalla in that which is truth, that in that which is truthful. So why is this? Why is it even better than jihad? Jihad has been legislated in order to establish the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa taala. Jihad isn't intended for itself, but it's intended for the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jalla to be established. Like was Salah. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, أقم الصلاة لذكري. Establish the Salah. Why? For my remembrance. Salah, all the actions are established. Why? For the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because there is nothing better than Allah Azza wa Jalla. And by you remembering Allah Azza wa Jalla, Allah Azza wa Jalla remembers you, and that is the best and the biggest of the the best remembrance, and the biggest is that which any everything the best is that which comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, through fasting it aids you in fulfilling this action, which is the best of actions, because when you eat, he says, لأن تناول الشهوات يوجب الغفلة. When you're constantly in desires and you're constantly in your desires, it brings about غفلة. It brings about what? Heedlessness. And it hardens the heart. And it covers and it blinds from the truth. وَيَحُولُ بَيْنَ الْعَبْدِ وَبَيْنَ الذِّكْرِ وَالْفِكْرِ. And it prevents the slave from remembering and thinking, pondering over the signs of Allah Azza wa Jalla, etc. طيب. And when the stomach is empty from food from food and drink, you know, القلب ويوجب رقته ويزيل قسوته ويخليه للذكر والفكر. So when the stomach is empty from food and drink, then the heart becomes full of nur, and it softens the heart, and it takes away its hardness, and it empties it for dhikr and fikr. And this is something that those who have tried it know. The meeting will end in a couple. So I request you join back. Oh, barakallah fikum, subhanallah. Actually, I'm not sure if we have, if the meeting, Ustad, does the meeting, end at 40 or?
Technical issue, there's a problem, so that we can come back if we, oh, other than that, okay? Jazakallah.
Okay, jazakallah, jazakallah khair.
Just let them know the others, please.
Okay. Okay, so inshallah, we will leave the group, inshallah, and then we will join again straight away. Barakallahu feekum. Jazakumullahu khairan. Bismillah. Yeah, now, inshallah, we'll join back, inshallah. Jazakumullahu khairan. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين نعم So we were talking about the remembrance of Allah and that the heart where the remembrance of Allah is established for it to be empty for the remembrance to enter fasting is a great means in establishing this. طيب. Number five. Number five. Number five. الصوم به يعرف الغني قدر نعم الله عز وجل عليه وقد حرمها كثير من الخلق. Through fasting, the one who is rich understands the qadr, how big the blessings of Allah Azza wa Jal is upon him. Because generally, the one who is rich, he's not tasted hunger, he's not tasted thirstiness. So, how do I put on the sound? Can everyone hear?
Yes, we can hear you.
Yeah.
Don't worry, we
طيب.
Can hear you, okay?
طيب. Number seven. الصوم سبب في التمرن على ضبط النفس والسيطرة. Fasting is a means to train yourself to control the nafs and not let the nafs be in control of you. And we mentioned this before. And this is very, very, very important. For those who weren't here when we spoke about the nafs is al-madaru al-nafs. Entering Jannah is based on your nafs. Did you purify your nafs? Did you control your nafs? If that is the case, and Allah Azza wa Jalla gave you knowledge, then in that case, inshallah, Allah Azza wa Jalla said the abode is Jannah. So we need to strive on taking the means, whatever means it is, to purify the nafs and also to control it. And if there's time at the end, there's one more thing I want to mention about the nafs. We mention in the end if there's time, bidnillah. طيب. Number eight, الصوم سبب الرحمة والعطف على المساكين. Fasting is a means. وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله. Fasting is a means to bring rahmah in the heart and to be nice to the people who are poor, because the sa'im, when he tastes the hardship of jur, when he tastes the hardship of hunger, في بعض الأوقات ذكر من هذا حال في جميع الأوقات أو غالبها. When he knows how hard it is to fast in just for a portion of the day, he then understands what it can be like. That this is a situation for someone all the time. Some people are going through what I'm going through, not just for a few hours, but every single day for weeks and for years. So he has some rahmah in his heart for the other people. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قَدْ خَابَ عَبْدٌ وَخَسِرٌ قَدْ خَابَ عَبْدٌ وَخَسِرٌ مَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ فِي قَلْبِهِ رَحْمَةً لِلْبَشَرِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said he has lost. He has lost the one. Assalamu alaikum. Anyone with the microphones on? Okay, خلاص. بارك الله فيك. الله أكبر الله أكبر. Okay, sorry, the adhan is just going on. 1 minute, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum.
أنا ديني لا أنا قصير. أدريكم سكتيني. No, maybe you would have been sealed.
Oh, hold on. What is it? Oh, hold on. What is it? لا إله إلا الله اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة محمد طيب جزاكم الله خيرا. Sorry for the wait. طيب number 9 الصوم فيه موافقة للفقراء بتحمل ما يتحملون. Fasting in it is a موافقة للفقراء. Is you have something in common with the people who are poor. So you go through what they go through, and we know the reward of the fuqara, what it is. So you will have that in common, and inshallah ta'ala, hopefully yawm al-qiyamah, we will be with al-fuqara. And we know that the fuqara will enter Jannah before the rich people by 500 years. Imagine five these people, 500 years, you are still waiting for your hisab, and 500 years, they've been in the pleasures of Jannah. And you're still waiting for your judgment. طيب. And then the Mu'allif said, أَصُومُ يُضَيِّخُ مَجَارِيَ الدَّمْ بِسَبَبِ الْجُوعِ وَالْعَطَشِ. Very, very, very important. The Mu'allif said that when you fast, what it does, it restricts the waves of the blood, the bloodstream, it restricts them. So when this happens, what does it do? It يقهر على بذلك الشيطان. You empower the shaitan. لحديث أن الشيطان يجري من الإنسان مجرى الدم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, indeed, the shaitan, he flows in the insan. The flow of the blood. So shaitan, he flows in our bloodstream. With the flow of the blood. And when he is free, the more movement he has, the more he's able to whisper, the more he's able to move our desires and make us do different things and whisper different things in our hearts and our heads. Those who are struggling of waswas, too much waswas from the shaitan, then fast. The more you fast, the more it tightens these majra. The shaitan can't do his work as much as he can. So the more that you fast, the more that you are hungry, na'am, the less room the shaitan has to roam around and to play his stupid tricks. La'natullahi alayh. So my brothers and my sisters, fast as much as you can. and inshallah we all fast in شهر رمضان, inshallah will be خير for all of us. طيب الصوم يجمع أنواع الصبر. Allah عز وجل said إنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب. Indeed the people of patience, the people of patience يوفون أجرهم بغير حساب, will receive their recompense, the rewards, they will receive them with no limits, with no limits. Allah Azza wa Jalla will pour the sabr, the reward upon them, sabr. Allah Azza wa Jalla will pour the reward upon them, sabr. And there's an extremely beautiful hadith that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَوَدُّ أَهْلُ الْعَافِيَةِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ حين يرون أهل البلاء الجزاء لو أن جلودهم قرضت بالمقاريض. That the people of sabr, the people of afia, those who are not afflicted with hardship, when they see يوم القيامة the amount of reward Allah Azza wa Jalla will pour over the people of sabr, the people who are afflicted and had sabr, they would wish that their skins were qurridat bil maqarid, that they were cut with scissors. Yawm al-qiyamah, you will wish that all your skin was cut with scissors. Why? Because of the amount that you see the sabr, those who had sabr are poured with sabr with no limits whatsoever from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. When you fast, you combine three types of sabr. You combine three types of sabr. The first being sabran ala ta'atillah wa hiya as-siyam. So the first type of sabr is a sabr over the ta'atillah, the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because you are obeying him by fasting. طيب. وَصَبْرًا عَلْ مَحَارِمِ اللَّهِ. And also there's a sabr, patience upon that which Allah Azza wa Jalla has made haram, and that is breaking your fast during, whilst you're fasting in Ramadan, and also the things that are generally haram, you abstain from them, especially when you're fasting. And it's also a patience over أَقْدَارِ اللَّهِ الْمُؤْلِمَةِ. You're having patience upon something Allah Azza wa Jalla has decreed over upon you, and that is something hard that Allah decreed upon you, which is al-ju' wal-atash, hunger and thirst. So the sa'im will have three, he has combined the three types of sabr. And we hope to be from those, when we fast, that Allah Azza wa Jalla makes us from the sabireen, and as a result, the reward yawm al-qiyamah will be with no hisab, it will have no limits. طيب. Number 12, and you know, as we're going through these points, the more you understand the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he said to Thawban, Thawban said, Ya Rasulullah, tell me, what is the best action? Tell me the best of actions. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, yes, upon you, alayka bis-sawm, fa-innahu la idla lah. Upon you is fasting, because there is nothing like it. There's nothing like sawm. Sawm is such a means in achieving closeness to Allah Azza wa Jalla, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam sometimes would be seen, he would fast so much that it would be said that he never breaks his fast. طيب, number 13, الصوم عبادة لله يظهر بها من كان عابدا لمولاه. Fasting is a proof that you are a slave of Allah Azza wa Jalla, because it shows that you follow Allah and you don't follow your desires. Because if you are someone who just follows your desires, when time of fasting would come, you would still eat and you still follow your desires. But you are leaving something for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. It shows that you are a slave of Allah Azza wa Jal. And if you are a slave to Allah Azza wa Jalla, then Allah Azza wa Jal has promised his slaves many, many things. Perhaps we will mention this. These things that Allah Azza wa Jal has promised his slaves. Another day, However, from the most great things of being a slave of Allah Azza wa Jal is that Allah Azza wa Jal has attributed his slaves to himself. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِي Allah Azza wa Jal said, oh my slaves, you're being attributed to who? To the greatest of the greatest, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What an honor. Even if you are someone who commits mistakes, even if you are someone who is constantly repenting, falling into sins, repenting, etc., Allah Azza wa Jal is attributing you to Him. And there is nothing greater than Allah Azza wa Jal. What an honor one could reach just by being a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tayyib, number 14. We have a few more minutes, inshallah. Okay, so this is the end of the chapter. And we'll take the next chapter, inshallah ta'ala, next week. Tayyib, we'll open the floor for questions and answers. If anyone has a question, you could ask now. If not, there's a few things I wanted to mention, inshallah ta'ala. So if you have a question, write it in the chat room or open your microphone and ask. And don't be shy, inshallah. Anything I know, I will answer. Anything I don't know, I will write the question down, inshallah, and give you the answer next week, bi'nillah. Or Ustad Faisal could answer the question. Any questions? طيب, if anyone has any questions, then what you do, write it in the chat room as I'm speaking, and then I'll answer it as soon as I see it. بإذن الله تعالى. طيب, what from the things I wanted to mention is about the nafs. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, فَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ Whoever fears the maqam of his Lord, standing in front of Allah Azza wa Jal, وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى And he prevents the nafs from the hawa. طيب. Why do people get chopped with scissors? طيب. So, Barakallahu Fiki, we mentioned the hadith where the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, يوم القيامة, listen attentively, okay? يوم القيامة, the people who are not afflicted with calamities in the dunya. So there were people who are people of the afiyah, people that Allah Azza wa Jalla blessed, and He protected them and didn't afflict them with calamities, and they died upon this. And if they were Muslims, they will have a lot of reward from Allah Azza wa Jalla. However, there's another group that Allah Azza wa Jalla loved so much that He afflicted them with calamities and calamities and calamities. And He also blessed them with a sabr. He allowed them and He gave them strength to be firm and to have patience and to give thanks to Allah Azza wa Jal. Yawm al-Qiyamah, when the people who are not afflicted with trials and tribulations, they see the reward that Allah Azza wa Jal blesses those of bala, those who afflicted, those who had a lot of trials and tribulations, they will wish that their skins were chopped with scissors. Why? Because if their skin was chopped with scissors, were cut with scissors, through the qadr of Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah decreed that upon them. And Allah Azza wa Jal also gave them sabr. Yani, for example, they were, why would people get chopped with it? If they were, for example, tortured. Some of the kuffar, they torture the people of Islam just because they say La ilaha illallah, they want to torture them. So if they are tortured, and some people are tortured in all types of punishments, so some people could be, their skins can be chopped, they'd be cut. Some people, we know that people before us, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, people before us, they used to be cut in half with a saw, from the top to the bottom, cut in half. Why? Because he's upon the deen of Islam. And that would not prevent him, that would not stop him, that would يعني, not make him leave the religion of Islam. So these people, Yawm al-Qiyamah, they will have, if they have sabr and they have patience upon these calamities, Allah Azza wa Jal will pour the reward over them, a pourance from Allah, without any limits. Only Allah Azza wa Jal knows how much this reward would be. طيب, what does the word nafs mean? It's a good question, النفس is difficult to explain, but what it generally means yourself. Generally, النفس means yourself. So an nafs, your nafs is you could say it's like your soul, it's what makes you. And your nafs it has bad, it needs to be purified. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, wa nafsin wa ma sawwaha, and the nafs and فألهمها فجورها وتقواها. He has, Allah Azza wa Jalla has taught the nafs, put in the nafs, is taqwa وفجورها وتقواها. The nafs has fujur, it has some wickedness, and it could also be given a taqwa. It could also be given that which will protect it. Allah Azza wa Jalla then said, قد أفلح من زكاها. He has surely succeeded, the one who purifies his nafs. If you purify your nafs, Jazakallah khair Nana for the question. What is a taqwa? How long do we have? We have a few minutes. Like, whoever purifies his nafs, put it this way, the nafs is something with you, in you, that needs to be purified for your success. The nafs is something inside you that needs to be purified in it for you, for yourself to be successful. يوم القيامة. Anyone who purifies his nafs, Allah Azza wa Jalla has promised success for this person. طيب, what would happen if you purify your nafs? If you purify your nafs, you will be guided to the things that are pure. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, الخبيثات للخبيثين والخبيثون للخبيثات والطيبات للطيبين والطيبون للطيبات. The evil people, the evil nafs, nufus, the evil things, the evil people are guided to the evil speech and evil things. But the pure people, the pure nafs, the pure people that are guided to are the pure speeches and the pure things. The more your nafs is purified, the more you'll be guided to the pure things, and the closer you'll get to Allah. I remember Allah Azza wa Jalla is tayyib, la yaqbalu illa tayyiba. Allah Azza wa Jalla is pure, and he does not accept except the one who is pure. So if you want to be accepted with Allah Azza wa Jal, you need to purify your nafs. And we said fasting is one of the biggest means to purify your nafs. What is a taqwa? Very good question. What is a taqwa? A taqwa is basically, in a nutshell, to make it easy to understand, is to make a shield. Okay, a taqwa from the word biqaya, to make a shield between yourself and the punishment of Allah Azza wa Jal. How do you make a shield between you and the punishment of Allah Azza wa Jal? It's simple. You do this by doing that which Allah Azza wa Jal has commanded you and abstaining from the things that Allah has prohibited you from. If you do this, why would Allah Azza wa Jal punish you? The only thing left for you is reward from Allah Azza wa Jal. So you are fearing his punishment. And as a result, you try to have a shield between you and the punishment of Allah Azza wa Jal by doing the things that he loves and abstaining from the things that he hates. So in a nutshell, this is at-taqwa. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, he loves the slaves who are al-muttaqeen. What is tajweed? Do you mean tajweed? Khalid, at-tajweed. At-tajweed is not really in the topic of this lesson, but tajweed is the rules on how to recite the Quran properly, on how to recite the Quran properly, as it was revealed, inshallah ta'ala. These are the rules pertaining to the recitation of the Quran. I'm not sure if this is what you are asking. If not, then let me know. طيب. Any more questions? No. طيب, بارك الله فيكم. طيب, one more thing I want to mention is the importance of seeking help with Allah Azza wa Jalla for all the acts of worship. So we're going to talk a lot about the virtues of this and the virtues of that, the virtues of this and the virtues of that. However, the slave cannot bring goodness to himself. The khair is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whenever you hear the virtues of this and you want to do some good, then straight away ask Allah Azza wa Jal. Say, Ya Rab, aid me upon this khair. Ya Rab, help me. I'm weak. I can't do this by myself. Ya Rab, help me to fast. Help me to increase in fasting. Help me to purify my nafs. Help me to do this. Increase in saying, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Because it is a word of seeking help. It's a dhikr of seeking help with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we will stop with this. جزاكم الله خيرا for listening. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. And we'll see you guys inshallah ta'ala next week. I'm not sure if everyone could what do you guys think about making these lessons twice a week? What do you think about making these lessons twice a week, Ustad Faisal? I don't know if you want to ask everyone if they want to make this. I'm free to make this twice a week or even more, forever once. So we could go through more of the book, inshallah ta'ala, and finish it before Ramadan. I don't know if you want to, if you want us to ask the students twice a week, now or later, another lesson or privately. Ustad Faisal, what do you say?
Inshallah, we'll look at it because the other day is Monday to Friday. Some of them are going madrasa, so we don't know. We'll check it. If there's any possibility of other day, could be other time also. Inshallah, we'll see. No problem. Jazakallah.
Wa jazakum khair jazak. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.